Oh, you know, just a few bucks. I'm short.
Get lost.
Well, I'll go try someone with a heart.
You do that.
Big fancy thing it was.
You preferred that, did you?
Sometimes.
I've eaten in 3 days.
Oh, say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna kill you.
You come near me, sailor, and I'll slash you up.
You put that knife down or you could be missing a hand.
What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. Was there insufficient feathers in your pillow?
I ain't lazy, Mr. Morgan. I'll work, but not this.
Well, I ain't cooking work.
I stood there laughing and crying. And rather than kill me, they took me and got me some food.
My husband and I, we shared the work. All of it. I was out in the fields. I can hunt, carry a knife, or use a gun. But I tell you, you keep me here, I'll skin this fat old coot and serve him for dinner.
Watch your damn mouth, you crazy goddamn fishwife.
Enough, both of you. Well, come with me then. You want to head out there, run with the man? So be it. But we do more than just hunting. We're hunted. And them things hunting us, well, they got guns of their own.
I ain't afraid of dying.
Good. You need anything, Mr. Pearson? Maybe me and Mrs. Ed are gonna take a little ride.
Yeah, sure. Here's my list, and can you post this letter for me while you're there?
Sure. Come on, princess. Are you coming with me then, woman?
So I've graduated from chopping vegetables to shopping.
Shut your goddamn mouth. You cooled down then yet?
I guess. But I ain't no scullion. And I sure as hell ain't taking orders from that sweating halfwit.
I guess we all gotta do our share, Princess.
Where's that letter?
Are you reading his mail now?
robbing and killing's okay, but letter reading's where we draw the line.
There.
Dear Aunt Kathy.
You are some now.
I haven't heard from you in some time. So I pray to the Lord above that your health has not deteriorated further. Blah, blah, blah. It's boring. Wait a sec. Listen to this. Since we last corresponded, I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself. Before you ask, I am still yet to take a wife, but I can assure you it's not for a lack of suitors. You ever actually even talk to a woman he ain't paid for?
Oh, look, we're all hiding behind something.
And what's this? Return to Tacitus Kilgore.
Oh, there. Now that's Dutch's idea. All males be sent to the same alias. Whatever we set up somewhere new, Strauss, he heads into town. Tells him to start expecting mail from a Tacitus Kilgore, whatever they changed it to. Here, give me that back. We got work to do. Okay, here we are.
So, what's the plan? I shoot the shopkeeper while you...
No! You insane?
I thought we was outlaws.
Outlaws, not idiots. We rob fools that rob other people. These people, they're just trying to get by. So you head on in there and you buy some food to eat. No guns.
You're sure?
This time, there'll be time for killing soon enough.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna go check the mail. Nothing exciting.
What did you get there, Harold?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing?
What's the problem?
How far?
You tell me I'm not.
Howdy, partner.
Can you believe I just heard one of them command a beagle? Can I help you, mister?
Yes, I would like to post a letter.
All right. Okay, no trouble.
Thank you.
Bye now.
Oz will still on time. I've been waiting on that thing to see.
I'm trying.
Try harder.
They say this winter's gonna be a bad one again.
I think this is everything.
Thanks. Here. Take that for yourself, okay?
Thanks.
Well, give it back then. Jesus. I didn't ask for his goddamn help.
Why don't you drive?
Okay.
Come on, lady. Get a move on.
I like Sadie, not lady.
I know.
Ha!
So, you get everything?
I think so.
And some new clothes, I see.
Don't start. I can wear what I damn well want. Like I told you, my husband and I shared all the work. I wasn't some little wife with a flower in her hair baking cherry pies all day.
Yeah, I don't doubt that. You sure look the part now. Won't be long before you're smoking cigars and playing the harmonica.
I'll have you know. I used to love playing the harmonica before. Well, my house and everything I own got burned to the ground.
I know. I'm real sorry about what you, you know. Maybe I'll keep my eye out for another one.
I don't want no pity. Just treat me equal and know. Nobody's taking nothing from me ever again.
Mm-hmm. Just don't kill the camp cook. Please.
Folks up to?
Just heading home.
You're in Lemoyne Raider country.
Keep it cool, Steve.
You need to pay a toll to pass through here.
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? How about you pull over right now?
Pull over?
That's what I said.
Hey, how's about this? Oh! Go, go, go!
Here.
Why?
Because you've caused enough trouble already.
I'm fine. Hey, watch it. We showed those bastards, huh?
Remind me not to get on your bad side.
And they was clearly planning to bushwhack us.
You did good. But that's a lot of mess to make near camp. Hope it don't bring anyone sniffing around.
Are you gonna tell Dutch?
Maybe. If he asks. But maybe not.
So who did they say they were? Lemoyne Raiders?
Yeah, something like that. Who knows? Anyway, don't you go ribbing Pearson about that letter.
How dare you? I wouldn't dream of it.
Right, you wouldn't.
I have traveled wide, making no small name for myself.
I won't be giving you no mail to post. Anytime soon, that's for sure.
I just want to peek in that journal of yours. The mind boggles.
Not a chance. Yeah.
Adler.
Not quite.
Well, I'd like to say I missed your refined conversations, but I'd be lying.
I enjoyed myself out there.
Yes, we, Mrs. Adler did okay.
At shopping?
Yes, at shopping.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Don't mention it. I would ride with you again, Mrs. Adler, if you will ride with me.
Maybe. If you prove you can handle yourself.
Well, they say I lack finesse, but I ain't afraid of gun smoke.
We got this, Arthur. You've already done me a big favor today. Okay, Miss High and Mighty. And nice pants, by the way.
Oh, shut up.
That's my fault, Sadie.
Evening. evening.
Well said, Miss Grimshaw.
That goes for you too, Mr. Morgan. We need food.
How are you today?
Evening, Arthur. Charles.
Miss Roberts.
Evening.
So, what do you think?
What do you mean?
About those two families. The rich ones in the big houses.
I don't know.
Go have a look around. See what you can find out. Calmly, I mean.
Sure.
Dutch and I, we both think there's money to be made.
I hope so. I'll see what I can find out.
Some poles and whiskey. Like the waves of the bay.
I don't need this
whiskey.
Right now.
I began to tumble and roar.
Good day, Mr. Morgan.
That's it, I think, yes. Oh, line. Damn.
friend.
Not bad at all. Afraid you're staying with me. Good to meet you. A stew without good meat is no stew at all, Mr. Morgan.
Idleness is the trail because it
can't means have that pot
I
go completely
so
empty.
You don't have to. That's not right, is it?
I guess not, miss.
You're right, not missing.
Sure. Might as well make some money off it. Just make sure it goes into the pot and not your pocket.
Thank you, Arthur.
I know, my dear.
What are we gonna do? Is Dutch a... I mean, he's all...
Arthur!
I know, dear.
So, Arthur, is it true about the bad luck?
What bad luck?
I just broke my pocket mirror, and I remember me old ma saying that a broken mirror means 7 years bad luck.
7 years? We won't see 7 years out. Don't be ridiculous. But if I find a mirror on my adventures, I'll bring it back for you.
Thank you, Arthur.